I was Google Summer of Code student for this year and did a project together with the GNOME Linux desktop and Nextcloud to basically work on improving the cloud experience on the Linux desktop. That was kind of the overall topic, and it consisted of three sub-projects, which were basically improving the Nextcloud client in terms of the setup wizard, building a registration API so that users can register for an account at a Nextcloud provider, and working on a Dbus API on the Linux desktop to allow sync clients to expose the services to the desktop environment. So the simplified setup process, this is basically what it's about. It should be easy for the user to get Nextcloud up and running even without knowing about how to set up a server, or that you even need a server for that. And of course it should be included in the client, so when you download the client, you can just get started without having a server. And this is basically what it looks like. You can, as always, enter the server address, or if you don't know how to deal with that, you can search for hosting provider or get help on how you can run your own Nextcloud. And if you choose a provider, you get a list of common providers in your country that are by default offer free plans, so you don't need to care at the beginning if you need to pay something there. So you can just give it a try, and you can click on create account and get this simple form where you enter your email address and name, and yeah, that's basically it. You click on create an account, and the sync client sets up the account and will just start syncing your files. On the provider side, there's a proof concept of a registration API that's very simple, but basically these three HTTP endpoints that providers need to implement to support this registration API. Of course, still a proof of concept, and we need to discuss a little bit with providers if the API contains everything that they need, if we need to, if we forgot something about that. So any provider-related people, feel free to come by and discuss that with me. Last thing was more part of the GNOME project. It's a Dbus API. Dbus is a message bus on desktop systems that is basically used by all front-end applications to communicate with each other. And we needed this because status icons, the little icons in the top bar in most operating systems, are deprecated on Linux. They are not available in Wayland natively anymore. And yeah, GNOME will most likely drop them in the next release. And it would, of course, make sense to have a desktop-independent solution there that will work with any file manager, desktop environment, and sync client. So I worked on a shared library that provides this Dbus API, and we have integration into GTK. And the basic implementation in the Nextcloud client as well, of course. And this is how it looks like. This is the GNOME file manager. You can see I have two synced folders, synced Nextcloud folders in the sidebar. You can see that one, the lower one, is currently syncing. And you can access all the actions that the status icon of the sync client provided. So you can pause the synchronization, access settings, quit the sync client there. You can check your recently changed files as well. And yeah, basically, that is the current state. We hope that other sync clients will also jump on that and implement that API, since there will be no other method for showing icon in the future in GNOME. And we, of course, hope that other desktop environments like KDE or XFCE will also implement the API in their file managers, or maybe find another way to show cloud providers where they are used. Yeah, and I want to thank GNOME very much, and of course Nextcloud and Roland for mentoring me. And yeah, if anyone wants to discuss on these topics, feel free. Thanks.